Hello. So yesterday I started 30 days of health and hope. And you may ask, well, why did I decide to do that? This is Dr. Susan Lavelle. And I decided to do that because we are in this era right now where there is so much fear and concern. But what concerns me is that there is a strong link between stress and immunity. And so when we are very, very stressed, our immune status goes down. So automatically that makes us think that we don't want to be overly stressed because we want our immune system, especially right now, to be as strong as it possibly can. So for instance, if we have, you know, if we're eating the perfect food, we're eating the best that we possibly can, we're sleeping, we got a perfect exercise regimen, we can still struggle if we are stressed, if we are chronically stressed. And why is that? And the reason for that is if we think back all the way to the Paleolithic days, essentially what it was, the stress hormones like cortisol and epinephrine and norepinephrine, all of these hormones that were made were there for short bursts of periods of time. They were there in case we were getting chased by a saber-toothed tiger or in case we were in some kind of danger. And so those same hormones would give us extra energy, extra power for that short burst of time. And it was perfect. That's exactly what we needed. And we still need them today. There are still times like that. Like if we're crossing the street and, you know, when a car comes, we want to be able to move fast. If there's a danger, we want to be able to move fast and have strength and energy. But if those continue, you know, if we continue with that stress, if we continue with those hormones, those same hormones start to suppress our immune system. So why is that? It's because they start to suppress because they are made to increase strength and agility and things of that sort, but they are not there for us resting and digesting and procreating and healing. So it's, you know, it's two different things. We need both, but for the majority of the time, we need those ones that are in the parasympathetic, the ones that are calming, resting, and an immune state. So what do we do? You know, a lot of us right now are very stressed and scared and concerned. So what do? We need to remember things that we can do to lower our stress levels. And one of those things is something that Charles Swindoll says. And he said, you know, 10% of what happens is in our lives is what happens to us. And 90% is how we react to it. And so we have to remember that we get to remember that we have the choice to react the way that we want. And so for today, what I wanted to do is share with you one of the very many, many ways that we can to lower our stress levels and to increase our parasympathetic response. And that is something I've talked about many times before. Simple as anything, it's just simply breathing. And so if you take deep breaths, you know, take a deep breath in, you hold it a little, let it out. And sometimes if you let out and with exhale a little bit longer than when you inhale, that's letting your body know that it's safe. And if you just try that 3 or 4 times, you know, when you start to feel a little anxious, you just do that 3 or 4 times and you'll start to feel the fear and the anxiety and the stress just sort of fade away. So that's one way. There are many, many other ways of breathing. I won't go into any of them right now. But there are other options that you can do, such as box breathing, you know, where you're breathing up for a count of, say, 2 or 3, and holding it, and then exhaling, and then holding it again. So that would be calling a box breathing. All of these different ways of breathing that will bring you back into a more parasympathetic state, a more calm state, less stress, higher immunity. Okay, so what I also wanted to do was let you know about tonight. I know it's down in some of the posts there, but we are doing a masterclass tonight about stress, hormones, and immunity. So we're going to really be going into a deep dive about what's going on, not only with COVID-19, because that is important. I mean, it's out there. We can't act like it doesn't exist. But we can react to it, you know, be that 90% of how we react to it. And that's what we'll be talking about, number one. We'll also be talking about the healthcare system right now and what we can do, is especially right now, to be more proactive about what we do so that we can heal ourselves from the inside out and starting with ourselves, with our family, with the world all around. And so that's going to be this evening at 7 p.m. I'm going to put the link below to the webinar room. I'd love to have you there. I'd also like to let you know that I'm giving an Amazon gift card to some of those. So you'll find out how to get that when you come onto the webinar tonight. But this is Dr. Susan Lavelle. I'm so excited to be here, to be able to share these 30 days with you. I look forward to being with you each and every day to help you to survive, not only survive, but to thrive this particular time. Okay, thank you. Bye-bye.